So why joint line? As we all know, joint line is an important technical goal of any total knee arthroplasty surgery, and failure to achieve this leads to anterior knee pain, mid flexion instability, patellar mal tracking, reduced range of motion, and thus resulting in lower knee scores and lower patient satisfaction rates. So by this study, or during this study, we try to analyze how precisely the robotic technology helps in restoring the joint line for the primary total knee arthroplasty. It was a retrospective study. We gathered data of the patients operated during November 2017 to March 2020. True plane anteroposterior radiographs of the patients were gathered and categorized into two groups. Group one being the robotic total knee arthroplasty, and group two being the conventional TK. 64 radiographs from 60 patients were obtained in the robotic group, while 66 radiographs from 60 patients were operated in the conventional group. For the analysis purpose, we calculated the distance of the joint line from the lateral epicondyle and that from the proximal tibiofibular joint, and named them as LEJL and PTF-JJL respectively. It is found that if the joint line is equidistant from these two bony landmarks, then it is said to have been successfully restored, as per the study published by Gavin et al. And Amarnath et al. And the way to calculate this was to find out the difference between LEJL and PTF-JJL. The post-operative functional, this is the image of calculation of the joint line. The post-operative functional outcome was analyzed using the Oxford D-score, which we all know as this is a 12 question scoring system that rates the pain status and activity level of the knee as it is reported by the patient. We included the patients who have undergone TK using robotic or the conventional method with the primary diagnosis of primary knee osteoarthritis, having varus deformity and FFD of less than 15 degrees. And we included only those cases whose true AP radiographs were available. We excluded the patients with the pre-op diagnosis of post-traumatic osteoarthritis, inflammatory arthritis, having valgus deformity with the pre-existing hip pathology and hip arthroplasty. After our analysis, we found that in the robotic TKA group, the LEJL minus PTF-JJL, this difference, the mean of this difference was found to be 0.334 with a standard deviation of 0.115. While that in the conventional group, this mean was found to be 2.304 with a standard deviation of 0.308. And the difference between these two means was found to be less than 0.001, which is highly significant. If we look closely at these figures, in the robotic TK group, the joint line was restored within 1 millimeter of what is considered as a near anatomical joint line. While that in the conventional group, it was found to be more than 2 millimeters. Also, the precision of the robotic method was independent of the age, gender, body mass index, and the side of the patient operated. As per the Oxford knee scoring system, at 12 months post-op, we found that in the robotic group, 68% of the scores were between 40 and 48, while 31% of the scores were between 30 and 39. While that in the conventional group, 51% of the scores were between 40 and 48, and 48% of the scores were between 30 and 39. Thus, showing that functionally, the outcome in robotic group was relatively better than that in the conventional group. Thus, we concluded from our study that the use of robotic technology in knee arthroplasty achieves a nearly anatomical position of the joint line, and the accuracy of the surgery can be significantly increased compared to the conventional method. Now, as with any other study, our study also had few limitations. Number one being, we could not compare the post-operative Oxford knee score to that of the pre-operative one, as it was a retrospective study and we did not have data of all the patients, the Oxford knee scoring data of all the patients preoperatively. Also, there was a deviation of 0.01 to 0.1 degrees in the perpendiculars drawn from lateral epicondyle and proximal tibiofibular joint to the joint line. However, this variation was very small to affect the overall observations. Thank you so much.